Coming up in today's video, we take a look at how I paint my 1 to 144th scale aircraft for the skies over India and Burma during the Second World War. This particular kit was crammed with detail, which really makes for an amazing finished product. The guide in this video explains how I both airbrushed and painted this aircraft. If you've enjoyed this video, don't forget to say so below. Okay guys, so I'm going to be painting a P47D Razorback. So this will be for my British in India project, and this will be using the Southeast Asia Command decals. So I'm using a 1 to 144th scale model here, and I'm going to be painting the canopy. I'm not going to be masking it this time around, so it's a really quick and easy way of painting my models. Unfortunately, when we're talking about scale models, the landing gear are normally only in the down position, so they don't always fit nicely, and you can see I've had to do some work to try and get them in the up position, but yeah, is what it is. I'm using the Platz Thunderbolt Mark 1 Razorback kit with the SEAC decals, so it's showing the RAF decals there as well, but it also includes three different decals for SEAC, which is obviously Southeast Asia Command for the British. And it comes with two aircraft, so it's really good, really detailed, as you can see, if my light doesn't block it, really, really good kit. So to start off with, I prime my model with Tamiya light gray, and then I paint the panel lines, or airbrush the panel lines, in Tamiya black. So doing this will just give those panel lines a bit more wear when we're airbrushing the other colors on top of it, and for this I'm using my Sparmax SP20X. So this is a really good mid-range to sort of amateur airbrush. It's relatively cheap, and it's really easy to use. It's actually really nice to use as well, so if you're looking into getting an airbrush, I'd recommend this as a first step. Then for the dark earth color, I'm using flat earth khaki yellow at a 2:2:1 ratio. Now, Tamiya are frustrating in the fact that they don't have like a dark earth dedicated color for the RAF. They have some dedicated colors, but their range is relatively small. But when we can get the mixings correct, or the mixture correct, it really does come out nicely. So yes, it involves some mixing, and some of you might be going, oh, I don't want to do that, it takes too much time. It takes a couple of extra minutes, but the end result is really worth it, in my opinion. Don't forget to always give them a second coat. There's always something you've missed, and you can also see that dark black panel lines that we've airbrushed prior to putting on this dark earth just popping through there. Then for the camo, I'm using RAF dark green. So this one is already set up for us from Tamiya, so it's fantastic. Just one color, we put it straight on. The masking I use here is just Tamiya masking tape. I think it's 10 mil, and I use my scissors. Very rough job here because I was running out of time. My tournament was within a week and I had a couple of other things that needed cleaning. So I just wanted to give a really rough job with the masking. Ordinarily, I'll take a lot more time and make the lines a little better, because the scissor can leave some sharp areas, and obviously when we're talking about RAF aircraft, they used curves with their camo scheme. And then for the bottom, I'm using sky gray from Tamiya, and again, same trick with the masking tape, just putting it over the wings. There was some curves towards the tail section, which I also captured, and you can see that I've left the black airbrush lines, and I'm just going over the top of them with this gray just to give them a bit of wear, and you'll see that once it's dry and in a better light, those panel lines really pop. I'm not really good with the correct terminology here, guys, so I'm no expert or anything like that. I just just go for it. Now, for some reason, my camera was playing silly buggers and was filming like this, but I'm just giving it a black wash. Now, the thing with this kit was the detail is fantastic. It's there, but the lines are very, they're not very thick. So I actually required two coats of this wash just to really get it to stand out. Majority of the time, you don't really need to do that. But yeah, sometimes you just need to give it a second coat. So make sure you've gloss varnished your model, and then you can put on your enamel wash. Then to clean it, I just use the same old trick that I normally do. I get a bit of odorless thinners on a bit of cotton bud, and I just start scraping away and cleaning it up. Lightly, of course. Sometimes you don't even need to do that. If you get it early enough, the wash is normally a little bit wet anyway, so you can clean it up and it won't remove what's in those panel lines, especially because those panel lines are so small already. Then for the canopy, I'm using Luftwaffe uniform World War II. Again, the canopy was really tricky to paint, so just take your time here with a really pointy ended brush. And if you haven't caught up with my socials, please do. I've got Facebook and I've got Instagram, and I'm also in the process of making up a Facebook supporters group. So if you've got any questions, you can hit me up on there, and hopefully if I can't answer them, there'll be some other supporters or subscribers that'll be able to help you out too. So if you want to get involved with that, let me know in the comments, because it still isn't up yet. I'm still a bit like, oh, should I? I'm getting a lot of positive feedback for it, so I probably will anyway. And then for any of the metallic objects, the machine guns in this case, I'm using German grey. If he had a tail that sort of stuck out, or a tail wheel I should say, sort of stuck out, German grey would be good for that rubber colour as well. But for this, it was only the guns that needed this German grey. Now I go over the windows on the canopy with Noil, which is a acrylic wash. So try not to get it on the rest of the paintwork, literally just try and capture the window. So use an old brush with a decent tip, or half decent tip, and just get that black on the outer edge of each window, or each part of the window. I forgot to mention that I also painted the nose of the aircraft, or where the prop meets the shaft is, in silver, and also the pitot tube, which is on the left part of the wing, in silver as well. And then now I go back over the window with that Luftwaffe uniform. So that black wash is going to darken that blue. Then we go back over it. So now we're layering it. I put the blue over it. I'm painting about 75% of the window in this blue, and I'm scratching away as I do. That's my technique. I just scratch, scratch, scratch until I'm happy with how it looks. You're trying to get a reflective look. Some people use black. My friend Stu over at Miniature Realms, he does a really good job with just using black or darker black colors. But for me, I like to use blue, and there's a whole range of different ways you can paint windows, so just work with what's best for you. And then I use a Luftwaffe uniform plus white grey, so at a 1-to-1 ratio. You could go 2-to-1 and then 1-to-1 and then finally white, but for this, again, I was in a rush, so I just went 1-to-1 and it worked really nicely. And this time now I'm painting about 50% towards the middle now, so we're not touching the outer edges of each part of the window. I'm just hitting the middle and about 50% of that, and I again just adding lines because you're trying to break up where the sun reflection would be, and obviously if it's flying through clouds or whatever, just yeah, whatever works for you. It's sort of like a bit of a YOLO moment. I'm just sort of winging it, and then finally I'm just painting what 10 to 25% of each window in white and just adding little lines right in the middle. And that's really going to break it all up nicely. So it's going to go from blue to white, and the white's going to meet in the middle. And it's a really good way of doing windows. It works for lights on tanks as well, if that's what you're going to be painting. Relatively straightforward, relatively quick, and there's really not a whole lot involved with it. But as I said, this might not be for you. And then for painting bombs, I went with the Vallejo Brown Violet. Then I gave them a wash in Umbar Wash, went over them in Brown Violet, and then highlighted them with Green Grey. And I also added a red band, because that's what I saw. The red band's a little bit bigger than what it probably should be, but hey, this is a Wargaming model after all. Or that's what I'm using it for, so I went a bit bigger, a bit more cartoony. Now we can go over the machine guns with that German Grey, and I'm just adding dots or lines about 50% of the machine gun. As I said, we've painted silver, so I'm going over that part of the nose area with base lead belcher. And same with the pitot tube. So majority of the time pitot tubes are silver unless they've got some sort of housing, but normally the tip is always silver anyway. And then there we go. So it's got a gloss varnish. We now want to go and spray that with a flat varnish. So I used Tamiya flat varnish for that. Ah, before you do that, you want to also weather it as well. So now I've weathered it, you can weather it to your own taste, it's really up to you. And then I've put a flat spray over the top of it. I can now hit it with gloss varnish, and this is just a Vallejo gloss varnish straight out of the bottle. And I'm just hitting each of those parts of the window. Again, be very careful here. You do not want to hit the paintwork outside of the window because then it's just going to look odd. So please don't mess up. If you do mess up, just hit it with another flat spray and go again. So there we go. There's another P47. This one's the bubble top canopy. But again, this is in India. And then there we go. So that is the finished product. So I went really light with the weathering, especially at this scale. We don't want to go too heavy. You could have put chips in the paintwork, but don't really want to do that with aircraft, especially one to 144 scale. I think it's come out really nicely. Those mixtures of Tamiya paints really do help. Again, this is just my opinion. For somebody that airbrushes, and I've done quite a bit of airbrushing over the years, I really find Tamiya, for me, works the best. So I always try and get the mixtures. There's plenty of people on Google that will tell you what the correct mixtures are. That's where I got this information from, so it's not like I've just come up with that off the top of my head. But anyway, I really hope that you enjoyed this. You think, like I do, it's come out really nicely. If you do, please let me know below in the comments. And I'm going to be honest, this is probably coming towards the end of my 14th army project. There might be a few little other bits that I might do, but I'm probably going to move on to the Japanese eventually, and then potentially the Americans. But if you want to see more 14th army stuff, let me know. There's plenty more that I can look at, perhaps different types of vehicles and some other infantry. But yeah, other than that, I really appreciate you guys watching, and if you're new here, please like and subscribe. But that's all from me. I'll stop rambling, and I will catch you guys at the next one.